What's up everyone, Howard Pinsky here, taking a look at a brand new, well, sort of a brand new feature. It was actually a feature that was introduced a few years ago in Photoshop, which was brought over from a plugin, and then it mysteriously disappeared for who knows why. But in this latest version of Photoshop, the oil paint filter is back. So let's take a look at how it works once again. So here I have a beautiful image that I grabbed from Adobe stock, and before I apply any filter, I'm always going to want to convert it into a smart object. So I'm going to right click on the layer and then convert to smart object. This will just ensure that it can always go back and edit that filter later on. So now that that's done, I'm going to head up to the filter menu, go down to stylize, and then we're going to find the reintroduced oil paint filter. And here it is, just as you remembered it. We have our stylization, cleanliness, scale, bristle details, and lighting, which we can turn on or off. So in this case, if I wanted nice, long, stylized strokes, I would just increase the slider, and you're gonna notice that the strokes are nice and stylized. If I wanted the strokes a little bit more messy, I can reduce the cleanliness, but I like my nice, clean strokes, so I'm gonna keep that increased. Now, if I do have my lighting turned on, which you can turn off if you like, you can increase the scale of your brush strokes if you want. So you can have them nice big strokes, or you can have them nice and small. Also, the bristle detail, I can increase to add even more detail or decrease it to have it very subtle. And like I mentioned, you can turn the lighting on or off, and you can also control the shine. If you wanted it very subtle, you can just turn it down, or you can crank it up to make it very prominent. But that doesn't look that great, so I'm going to keep it nice and low. And if I zoom in on this document, you can really start to see some of the great detail that the oil paint filter brings. Here's the before, and here's the after. Of course, you're probably noticing it does change the shape of the man in the middle just a little bit, and that's when you can go back and start to play with the stylization options. If I decrease the stylization, you're going to notice some of the detail of that man is starting to come back, but the brush strokes aren't as long and stylized. So you have to decide what direction you want to take your oil painting. In this case, I don't mind if he's distorted just a little bit. I love those long brush strokes. So I'm going to accept my changes by pressing OK, and here's what my oil painting now looks like. Now there is an additional step that I like to take that really isn't part of the oil paint filter, and that's adding a canvas texture. So I'm going to go ahead and create a new layer in my layers panel. And then whether you have an image of a canvas or a texture, this should work the same. So I'm going to go into my paint bucket tool over here in the tools bar. I'm going to choose pattern at the top, and I have these custom canvases from Kyle Webster that I'm going to simply load in. And if I click on it, you'll notice I have a few different types of canvas. And I can just try out a few of these to get the exact canvas that I'm looking for. That one looks pretty good. I'm going to quickly desaturate it, Command and Control, Shift, and U. And then in my layers panel, I'm simply going to set the blend mode to soft light. And if you zoom in, you'll notice we have a little bit of a canvas texture now over top of the oil paint. If I turn that off and then back on, that looks pretty nice, and I can decrease the opacity so it's not too strong. And here's what the final result looks like. Here's what we started with. We started with a great image that I found on Adobe stock. Of course, you can use any image that you've taken or you found on the internet. Here's the oil paint filter and then the canvas added afterwards. Let's take a look at one more example, slightly terrifying, but this is an image of me, a headshot that was taken at Adobe Max. Again, I'm going to convert this into a smart object, head up to the filter menu, down to stylize, and then choose the oil paint filter. And this is where stylization and cleanliness really come into play. As you can see, with these values cranked up, we have some very strange brush strokes going on, and detail is definitely lost. So in this case, I definitely want to decrease the stylization a little bit to bring out some of the detail in my eye and my very poorly grown beard, and maybe decrease the cleanliness just a little bit as well. And that's looking pretty decent. And I may in this case actually want to turn off the lighting so we don't have those brush strokes going on, to make it a very soft oil painting. And I'm pretty happy with that result, so I'm going to press OK, and just like in the last example, I'm going to create a new layer, add that texture, desaturate the texture, set the blend mode to soft light, and then decrease the opacity so it's not that strong, and now we have a really nice looking oil painting. Now you may have noticed that once I added the canvas texture to this picture, the oil painting details from the previous layer were kind of lost, and that's why it's so important to use smart objects. I can simply double click on the oil paint filter in the layers panel, and then adjust the settings as I need to. So I'm going to increase the stylization just a little bit, increase the cleanliness, and I've brought back a little bit of that oil painting look that was lost when I added that texture. And that's a look at the oil paint filter, one of the many new and updated features in the latest version of Photoshop CC. Thanks so much for watching, everyone. Make sure to follow me on Twitter, subscribe to my YouTube channel for more Photoshop tutorials, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Take care.